All right, let's move into the outplay part of the game. This is the conditions that are put on you. You have to build shelter. You have to compete in challenges. You have to deal with idols and advantages or twists and switches. Edge of Extinction was a big part of the outplay this season. Who wants to get us started?
I'll get us started. Guys, there were a lot of idols out there. I found them because I got out there and hustled and worked hard and found them. Why didn't you?
I was looking a lot, and you may have heard many screams as I was looking every time I came across a bug or a lizard or a crab hiding in a tree hole. I was looking, and I was looking so well, I found your fake one. So I found an idol.
I looked a little bit also, but I was on the side with the numbers for every vote but one, so I knew it wasn't going to be the end of the world.
And Chris, do you think that it's an unfair advantage that not only do you come in with just 3 days left in the individual game, but you have all this extra information and strategies you received from the Edge of Extinction?
Actually, the Edge of Extinction was an unfair advantage to me, despite even having information, because I had to play the biggest possible game with 3 days that I could possibly play. So I flushed an idol my first vote, played an idol correctly my second vote, won immunity challenge on the final day, and then biggest move of the game, by far, give up my necklace to earn my spot back into the game by making fire against the number one competitor in the entire season. And that's the best that I could possibly do. There was no other scenario.
From my perspective, I think it's an unfair advantage because he didn't find that second idol. Like, that was given to him. He would have been voted out if he hadn't been given that idol.
My question then is, Chris, how do you think you convinced him to give you back half the idol?
Because in this game, we so easily forget about social capital. It's 38 seasons of Survivor, and we really have forgotten that you cannot treat people like chess pieces. The game we fell in love with was not just about deceit and backstabbing and blindsiding. You cannot think that someone who is going to be loyal with you to the end is someone you can screw around. So you're asking me why? It's because my relationship with Devins was real. And when I told him I wanted him to go to Final Four, I meant it.
I respect everything you're saying, but if you want to talk about classic Survivor, then it's surviving 39 days. It's not getting voted out on day 8 and then coming back on day 35 and having a chance to win this game. So I don't think you can talk about playing classic Survivor and then, you know, you having this opportunity.
But Gavin, the game evolves, and this is the theme, and it's the Edge of Extinction, and Chris played with the days that he had in the game, and to see what he was able to do in the last few days, hoping that you would have done just a percentage of that. Like, 39 days isn't everything. What did you do with those 39 days, you know?
I built the social bonds to get me through this game. Like, being over there, you don't have to worry about anything. You don't have to worry about someone backstabbing you or blindsiding you. Like, I'd love to reconnect with Eric and Aubrey and all these people that I've done my wrongs to. So I feel like I'm at a disadvantage in that way.
And to support what Gavin's saying, there's a lot of stress and mental fatigue that takes place in the game that you let go of when you're on the Edge of Extinction. So there's a balance there.
Look, the theme is not on trial yet. You three are on trial. I think it's all about what everybody did with the hands they were dealt. You know, I'm actually hearing some really good answers, but sometimes in this game, it's about some player making a play better than you. You know, that's it, like.
Well, I think there's another side to that. Could everyone here that didn't get their name written down raise their hand? Everybody, jury included, who never had their name written down?